It makes me very proud, especially to sit here, to be still fairly young and also be a Black author. Most people don't know that. Most children authors, there's less than 9% of us that are people of color. So, you know, I take that very, very seriously. It's just something that I know that people should always know, because you never know who you're sitting in a room with, because there's opportunity for these kids to become the next Black author or the next author in general, because there are young authors and a lot of them are pretty groundbreaking right now, especially in the midst of
you become a role model.
Welcome to the award-winning author show. I'm your host, Lisa Umina, CEO of Halo Publishing International. If you're ready to become an award-winning author, then let's get started.
Thank you for joining us today. I have the pleasure of spending my morning with Jordan Sullen. He is an exceptional author. He's one of our favorite authors. He's put together three books so far: Mally in the Middle, Flower, Flower, Give Her Power, and Numbers Don't Lie. So I want to spend some time with you, Jordan. I want you to take our listeners, our viewers, on your journey from NFL player to children's book author and illustrator to writing a series. How did that all come about? Can you share that with us?
I would definitely say it was quite the journey. As you know, I reached out to you at a time where I felt like it was probably one of the most transitional moments of my life for any athlete, really. I'm just making that jump from the playing field, the locker room, the team environment that you really become, like, succumb to, and making that leap of faith into the literary world. It was always something I knew I wanted to do, even with Molly and Jasper, you know, being able to create those characters, having a shelf of those characters so that I can focus on my career, focus on college, focus on professional football. And then sometimes you just know. I had this feeling that it was time for me to make the transition. And I did that, called you. You worked with me to to no end. And, you know, we went through some tough times together. But thankfully, you know, we sit here today, three books later. My career
Three books later. So you're talking about a rough time in your life. A lot of people use that as an excuse not to accomplish.
Dream, create
a legacy, right? And here's you. And I won't go into it. We don't need to, but you were going through a lot in your life. Not to mention, I think you had a couple moves too. You're moving from one place to the next.
Yeah.
Too, during writing the book and illustrating the first one, Mally in the Middle.
Yeah. At that point, you know, I was moving all the way from Canada at one point, you know, reaching out to you. Trying to touch base with you in New Orleans, because I knew that New Orleans would be home temporarily until I made a move elsewhere. Jumped into health and wellness following my football career. That was, I would say, a tenfold experience for me. I was able to help a lot of people, take care of their bodies. I always had a passion for fitness, but health and wellness became something that's still kind of near and dear to me. You know, that kind of went hand in hand with the fact that I didn't suffer any injuries. Thank God I didn't suffer any injuries during football. So it was kind of a story to tell, you know, people kind of living vicariously through me and in these facilities that I was running in the Houston area, even some that I've run in the Atlanta area. But yeah, that was definitely my transitional point. And, you know, you tie that in with writing books at the same time. You can only imagine how busy I've tried to keep myself, especially trying to just make sure that my imagination expands and expands over time. I mean, you know, just as well as I do, you know, I hit you at the most random times, like, hey, I have my next book idea. You know, even as we sit right here right now, I do have my next book idea sitting in my head. I probably have the next three books sitting in my head.
Wait, I don't want the fiance to, you have a wedding you're planning. So that has to, I think that has to take priority.
Yeah, absolutely.
Before this next book comes
absolutely
out.
She would say the same.
So, you know, there's this other part of you that I admire. It kind of mirrors off even how I am as an author myself. It's, you have the entrepreneurial skills. You know, you get this. This isn't dress rehearsal. This is life. We only have one chance to make it, right? To make what we want and putting our voice on the right side of history too. That's important. Let's talk about that, because as you were putting your series together, I think the one that really tugged at my heart too was during this whole election, and we're not going to talk politics. We're going to talk about something more sensitive than that, and that's the Black Lives Matter. And we're celebrating Black History Month, and again, it's just an honor to have you today. But in doing that, you are the showcase, our author that we're going to talk about that. Like, what did that mean for you? Because you were releasing that story right around the time when, well, protests, but then there was also the other side of that. Like, how did that feel putting your voice out during that time?
I would definitely say it was special for me. You know, even as I sit here today with you, this is actually one day after I had the pleasure of sitting alongside another young Black author in the same room. And we actually read our stories. I read Numbers Don't Lie to my first group of kids here in Kennesaw, Georgia. And it was a very mixed room of kids. So even in that moment, I had the opportunity to kind of speak to those kids about what making the transition to a city like Atlanta has meant to me, especially. You know, I've even posted some pictures on the front lines of these protests, obviously peaceful protesting. But yeah, you know, it's been an opportunity to, you know, walk the same streets that Martin Luther King once did, being impactful as possible. Right. I mean, we walked miles, just so many different people, so many different walks of life coming together for one cause. And Atlanta has definitely been instrumental. And, you know, as you say, we're not going to talk politics, but Atlanta has been very, very instrumental. The state of Georgia in general has been instrumental in changing the Senate and, you know, getting the first woman of color in the White House, you know, things of that nature. You know, people have definitely relied on Georgia to make these things happen.
Exactly.
So to live in it, you know, to live in this state and live in such a special city like Atlanta now, it makes me very proud, especially to sit here, to be still fairly young and also be a Black author. Most people don't know that most children authors, there's less than 9% of us that are people of color. So, you know, I take that very, very seriously, especially, you know, yesterday I could tell when I said that statistic, the kids were kind of wild. Some of the adults were actually wild, but it's just something that I know that people should always know, because you never know who you're sitting in a room with, because there's opportunity for these kids to become the next Black author or the next author in general, because there are young authors and a lot of them are pretty groundbreaking right now, especially in the midst of
you become a role model, Jordan, in so many levels. I mean, again, releasing a book like this, I'm just going to show you, like, he did all these amazing, all these little tiny illustrations, but it's so colorful and it's so big. The message is so big because it came out at a time where we needed to hear your voice. And like you said, it's, you know, we're called to do this. We have a choice. We do nothing or we do something, but that change has to start with us individually. And I loved the fact that you rushed this through to get it in the hands at the right time in front of the right audience and doing the right thing and doing what we're supposed to do. But yeah, you become a role model to so many children of all ages by doing something you're passionate about. I mean, that's what this is about, right? And so what kind of message do you have for upcoming authors that are still afraid of doing that first book? What kind of advice can you give them?
I would definitely say utilize every resource that you have. You know, for instance, I only found Halo because I had to find other people that I'm just like, yeah, they don't fit what I'm going for. You know, they've sent me a million emails wanting to accept my manuscript. And this was years ago, but I still get emails from certain people as of this day. As you know, I would definitely say that I've been pretty, you know, loyal when it comes to Halo, understanding that there is a team element to, you know, to what we've been able to build. Like I said, it felt like whatever I was going through at those different times, you know, you guys were kind of right by my side with that. And here we are in 2021. But I would also say, you know, you have to be patient. As I told you before, Molly and Jasper sat as characters on a piece of paper for almost 10 years before I actually reached out to you and said, hey, I'm ready to make a book out of these guys. I have a really cool old picture when I first presented Molly and Jasper to a summer camp in my own community. And I presented it as coloring sheets. I still actually offer kids coloring sheets when I give out the books and so forth and so on. Yeah, it just took me back because I was in the midst of college football, everything that comes with that.
You made it a priority. I think too, we're in a pandemic. There's another calling for you, and I know you know this, is to be in front of your audience, and that would be at schools, nonprofit organizations, hospitals, anyone that would crave to hear this message. like I said, you are a role model. This is a position that you earn, and it's different from any other business you possibly can get into. I know you also have another business you haven't talked about yet, but we're going to give that clue away right now. You started a hat business. You have a hat store, don't you?
Yeah. So, you know, I have two very close friends. You know, they started Fruition Hat Company. I came along much later, I would say, you know, but it's very, very inspirational because, you know, these two guys, they're from Detroit, Brian Chapman, Stenzel Jackson. They built something that so many people have taken a liking to. I've always been passionate about hats. And, you know, I stumbled across the opportunity to, you know, join alongside these guys. And our team is still relatively small, but we've made a huge impact.
You had some celebrities in there.
Right. Yeah.
You got to say who visited the store?
Yeah. So we've been pretty fortunate in that aspect. And that's what's so great about Atlanta. But, you know, we've had the Anthony Hamiltons. We've had R&B legend Kim. We've had top model Eva Pickford come in before. I mean, the list really goes on. There's so many stylists in Atlanta who style some of your favorite celebrities. So yeah, we've really become kind of a one-stop shop for a lot of people. And to be honest with you, you know, we have a lot of people that stop into our stores and they sometimes don't want to go back to the previous hat company that they were with.
You have so many. You have so many different kinds. Seriously, yeah. I really follow you. You know, I'm a fan of yours too. All right. Lastly, I want to say, I want to ask you a question. You've done all amazing things already, and you're so young. You're so young. But, you know, as we have this calling, and we have a few, right? I mean, you can see that in our life. But how do you want to be remembered, Jordan?
I really want to be remembered by the things that I did for everybody else. You know, for my family, one thing that's always remained pretty near and dear to me is, you know, honoring my mother and my father. So I take that very seriously as I've grown up. There's been times where, you know, you kind of give yourself excuses like, oh, I'm so busy with football. Oh, I'm so busy with college. I'm so busy with this. I'm so busy with my relationship. But not understanding that, you know, we will outlive our parents, you know, more often than not. So I try to take that opportunity to talk to my parents almost every day. Me and my mom, it's been a pleasure having my mom learn how to effectively text. So that's been great.
But other than that, you get FaceTime with her? Has she learned
right,
that?
Yeah. I FaceTimed her last night. But yeah, that's the type of things that I want to be remembered by. I want to be remembered as a great husband, a great family man, and just, you know, a lover of my people, especially the people who look like me, a lover of all people, but definitely people who relate to me, who come from the same situations that I've come from and found a way to rise from the ashes. So that's what I want to be.
Beautiful, Jordan. Beautiful. And you didn't mention kids as a father.
Yeah,
you didn't mention that part. Aren't these books going to be for those kids? All 10 of them. How many are we making?
So what's funny
his
is
faces my like this. He went,
right. So what's funny is that we were asked yesterday, you know, when we were going to have kids, we both kind of looked at each other like,
I just said, you didn't mention that. I wasn't pushing. Are you having kids already? You still have to enjoy the honeymoon, right?
Right. Absolutely.
So we do that first, right? Well, thank you for being a part of our show today.
Yeah,
and looking forward to book four, 2021 book four. And you just keep doing what you're doing. You're doing amazing things and affecting a lot of people with your beautiful smile, your passion, your heart. And you definitely will be remembered, Jordan. You're an important person to me, too. Thank you so much for trusting me and my company to publish your stories, your voice. It means a lot to me as well.
Thank you so much, Lisa. It's been a pleasure joining you today. I'm sure we'll have so many more opportunities to do this. So thank you.
Absolutely. And you can find his books on Amazon, Barnes & Noble, Books A Million, Goodreads. Any store has his book, has all three of them. You can order those. As soon as you watch our show, I'm sure you're going to be inspired to do so. Or you can get an autographed copy by following him on Instagram, absolutely, LinkedIn, Twitter. Just tell him, I want an autographed copy from you. And I'm sure he'll do that for you as well.
Thank you for listening to today's episode. If you're ready to publish your book, please submit your manuscript on halopublishing.com. Or you can download our free publishing guide to learn everything you need to know about the entire self-publishing process. Start writing your legacy today.